But I think you get to explore an emotion. You get to kind of deal with the emotional tapestry of something over a longer break. So I loved it. It was really wonderful to have a kind of concise beginning and end. It was a really interesting experience. He was the first cab off the rank, really, because finding a child of that age to act is a very complicated process. So we had to start that very early on. We also had to get visas for this child as well into Australia, which is no mean feat. So it was very sobering to have a five-year-old as a centre of centre of the story for half the movie. So you know, we put a lot of resources into that, and we didn't take it lightly. So we did a very extensive search all over India, pretty much, and just did a lot of hard work, a lot of workshopping, and eventually we found him. The kids in India are just staggering. They just have this spirit that's so infectious, and I don't know. It's even to this day, I'm kind of really grateful to have had that experience with them.
And with the adult members of the cast, how did you assemble that, and how long a process was that for you?
Well, I mean, you know, it was pretty much a traditional kind of casting process, but what I found is that people just drew themselves to the material. It just became quite obvious who was right, and there was a lot of serendipity. So it was just one of those things. I mean, Dev rocked up very early when Luke and I were still scribbling out the arc of the story. He rocked up and, you know, kind of barged into the living room. He was like really excited about this story, wanted to be a part of it. So it was just one of those stories that a lot of people felt passionate about and really wanted to be in on. So it just, the story kind of drew everyone into it, really. We do have our production company over there, iTopper, in contact, regular contact with him, checking on his welfare. We've got things in place to kind of support him through school and all sorts of things. So they're really flourishing, I think, and still leading a kind of a normal life, which is important, not trying to kind of hero worship them or anything like that, keeping them kind of even. But it's very special, like when little Sonny came out to Australia, I was in the middle of a rehearsal with these guys, and he arrived, and he came in the door, and we just hugged. We hugged for like 10 minutes. You know, he'd had such a beautiful relationship. So I think everyone just had a very life-changing experience, including the kids.
Yeah.
Look, for me, it was really important that we kind of captured India. I mean, a lot of movies, I think, romanticise India. They go and shoot in easy places. They don't have the kind of courage to get it on screen. So I was really determined to bring audiences into India in a way they'd never have been. So I found that very exciting. And, there was even a scene where Saru is being, you know, chased by these child snatchers, and it happens like 2, 3 a.m. in the morning, and he kind of runs out onto the Howrah Bridge and it's all empty. I mean, when I arrived in Calcutta very late at night, I realised all the streets were empty. So, like, just that understanding, I go, well, we can really see the bridge if it's 2 in the morning, you know, and so that's kind of how I worked, and I think how we got the most out of India.